Hello everyone, and welcome to this video tutorial on how to get started with the Syncfusion circular gauge in a Xamarin.Forms application. The circular gauge, also known as the radial gauge, helps you display numerical values on a circular scale format. By customizing the circular gauge, we can create major applications such as speedometers, temperate monitors, dashboards, modern activity gauges, direction compasses, and more. Now I will showcase some demos which were created using the Syncfusion circular gauge. This is a demo for the temperate monitor. Here, multiple color ranges are displayed using the range collection feature, and the current temperate value is indicated by a needle pointer. The temperature message and current point value is specified using the header feature. This is a memory progress sample. It shows that you can easily customize the gauge to be semicircular in shape. For this direction compass, the scale labels indicate direction. In this annotation demo, different small gauges are used as annotations in the main gauge to design a clock application. Now, I will show you how to add a circular gauge to a Xamarin.Forms application and configure pointers and scales. I have already created a Xamarin.Forms project using Visual Studio 2017 with .NET Standard. As you can see, we have four different projects in the solution. One for Android, one for iOS, one for UWP, and one for code sharing. For our first step, we have to add the required assemblies for the circular gauge from the NuGet Package Manager. To do this, right-click on the solution and choose Manage NuGet Package for Solution. And from the next screen, choose the browser tabs and search for syncfusion.xamarin.sfgauge. Now select the sfgauge NuGet package for Xamarin.Forms and select all the projects and then click Install. Now, all the assemblies are installed. One more step is required for Android to refer to the mono.android.export assembly. To do this, right-click on References and choose Add Reference. Choose the mono.android.export assembly and click OK. Set the Android project as the startup project. Open the XAML page for the Getting Started mainpage.xaml file. Here, a default label is added to this page. I will remove that label and add a circular gauge. Before continuing, I want to show the final output of what we are going to create using the circular gauge. Here, from 0 to 100 is a scale range. Multiple range segments are colorized to indicate speed warnings. Different types of pointers are used to indicate the current point value. A header is used to display some information about this gauge. Now I'm going to show you the steps to add these features using the circular gauge. To add a circular gauge to this page, the first step is to add the namespace of the circular gauge. Syncfusion.sfgauge.xforms is the namespace. The next step is to initialize the circular gauge. Now run and deploy to see the default view of the circular gauge. This is the default view. By default, a single scale is added to the gauge. The next step is to add circular gauge features such as pointers, ranges, and headers one by one. The circular gauge contains a collection of scales. Each scale contains a collection of ranges and pointers. For this demo, I will be adding just one scale. To do this, create the scales collection for the circular gauge. To add a scale, create an instance of a scale and add it to the scales property. Set scale start value as 0 and end value as 100. You can add any number of scales based on your needs in the scale collection. In this scale, we have to add multiple points and ranges. Add multiple ranges to the scale to indicate the warnings using ranges property. I'm going to add three types of colored ranges to this scale. The first range's start value is 0, and its end value is 35, and its color is green. The next range's start value is 35, its end value is 70, and its color is orange. And the last range's start value is 70, its end value is 100, and its color is red. Now the ranges have been added. Additionally, we have to set the margin for the circular gauge to reduce its size to avoid UI stretch. Run and view the output of the current code. Here, you can see the single scale with a range of 0 to 100 and three types of colored ranges. The next step is to add pointers to the circular gauge scale. There are three types of pointers available in the circular gauge: needle pointer, marker pointer, and range pointer. You can add any one of these pointers to indicate a value. In this tutorial, I'm going to add all three pointers. I will add the pointers one by one using the pointers property. First up is the marker pointer, which will point at the value 70. Next is the needle pointer, which will point at the value 60. And last is the range pointer, which will point at the value 90. Now, run and view the output of the current code. Here, all three pointers are added to the gauge. You can see the needle pointer points to the value 60, the marker pointer points to the value 70, and the range pointer points to the value 90. The final step to set up the circular gauge is to add a header. We can use the header to display a message, description, or the current value of the gauge. We can add multiple headers to the circular gauge using the header collection property. In this demo, I will add only one header, which just shows the text speedometer. To do this, create a header collection for the SF circular gauge, and then add a header element. Set its text property to speedometer. And then set the foreground color to black, and the text size property to 20. The header has been created. All the features have been added to the circular gauge. Let's take a look at the final output. You can see the circular gauge scale from 0 to 100, different types of colored ranges, multiple pointers, and the header. In the next step, we will see the same output on other platforms such as iOS and UWP simply by changing the startup project. To see output in iOS, set the iOS project as startup. I have already configured my Visual Studio to connect to Mac on my network. This is required to deploy an iOS application. Additionally, Xamarin does not load the renderer assembly by default in a Xamarin.Forms iOS project. In order to resolve this, you must manually call the CircularGageInit method and the FinishLaunchingOveride method of the AppDelegate class in the iOS project. To do this, expand the iOS project and select the AppDelegate class. In the FinishLaunching method, I am going to call sfgagerenderer.init method. Type in syncfusion.sfgage.xforms.ios.sfgagerenderer.init. Now run and view the output of the iOS application. This is the final output of the iOS application. Now we will look at the output of the UWP application. Set the UWP application as startup. Now run and view the output of the UWP application. This is the final output in UWP, which is similar to the other platforms. And that's it. Thank you for joining us today, and we look forward to seeing you in the next one.